Let me be something. You wanna keep your head? If I ain't your girlfriend, I won't let go your head.
Right, so we're just gonna 120 on a DA. No backing pad. The area we wanna Plastic World. Right, we DA'd it down back to bare plastic, so now it's at Plastic Welder and do some welding. Right, once your soldering iron's hot, you can see the crack there. We're going to just poke a hole straight through the end of the crack to stop it, and then I've cut. If you can't find out what sort of plastic the bumper is, get hold of any plastic that the bumper is, just on the inside of the bumper somewhere, you'll always find somewhere to cut a bit of plastic off. You know it's the same material. So what I've done is just cut a piece off the inside, and we'll use this to weld in the crack once we've scored it out. So we just put a hole straight through the end of the crack. The crack out with the soldering iron, which will give us something nice to put our new plastic in. See, we've bleed it out. So what I'll do is I'll melt this piece of plastic into the V. If you've got a plastic welder, it will have like a hot air gun on it. I haven't got, and you could literally just melt this in with the hot air. Basically, once we're done, hopefully, we shouldn't have to put any filler in it. We can just DA out the area, get a nice flat finish on the plastic. And then if we DA it out and got any low spots, we can just go over and put some more plastic in. Saves stick and filler in it. Heat it up, smooth it off into the existing areas so it doesn't just pick out. let that cool off, DA that down, and hopefully we'll get that nice and strong, and hopefully no need for filler. So I'll stop you there and we'll come back once I've DA'd that down. Right, I've DA'd that down now. As you can see, crack's gone, which left with a few lows. So I've got another piece of plastic. We'll just go in, fill that into all these little holes. So hopefully then we can DA that down, we won't need any filler. Finish it in 320, ready for some high build primer. And yeah, hopefully we'll be laughing. So we'll put this bit of plastic in and yeah, see how we go. See that we've filled them in. So we'll let that cool, DA that off, and then we're ready for some high build primer. So we'll let that cool down, didn't take long. DA it flat. I was doing it with 80, so we'll switch now to 120. Switch back to 120. And then we'll go over it with 320 and yeah, finish it there. So now we're 320 on a soft back. So as you can see now, filled in those little holes, DA'd it all down, and we're left with this, a tiny little mark there, which will, the high build will get that, you can hardly feel it. But yeah, solid, bending it, no cracking. Yeah, so it's all done, we'll stick some high build primer on the bits we want. We've also got a bit up here. Was damaged, so we'll just DA that all down, we'll high build that, and we're laughing. Right, we've scuffed it all down, ready for primer. I'm just going to go do a bit of flip edge, soft edge masking, where we want to prime, so where we don't want to get primer. Stick this down, it just stops you getting a hard edge. Um, bit of plastic primer, just rub over the bare plastic. Make sure that paint sticks to it.
So yeah, bare plastic,
adhesion promoter, plastic primer, whatever you call it.
Right, so we're all high build primed now, as you can see. We'll let that dry off under these lights for about half an hour. Then we can rub it down, get the bumper all ready for some paint. Cool girl.